After living the dream for a month, it is time to leave the Philippines. Sometimes you just wish that memories will last forever. And this entire month in the Philippines is definitely one of them. But from one outstanding adventure and onto the next one, the next month we'll be exploring Indonesia, and this place has so much to offer. I hope you are just as excited as I am for this next series. So, without further ado, let's start the series off with a full day of exploring at the enormous metropolis of Jakarta. Alright guys, so welcome to the enormous metropolis of Jakarta here. We have just woke up and are on our way to go and catch some breakfast. There should be an amazing breakfast. And here at the hotel, the city here, it looks crazy. Wow, the view out here is just such a big city. I think it's the biggest city I've ever been in, actually. In Jakarta here and the small cities around, there live 31 million people. It is crazy.
Wow, 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 look at this, guys. Amazing breakfast buffet here. I'm excited about this, actually.
Just look at all of the small cakes you can have here. I get more and more hungry just looking at this. Let's eat. My mission of today is to eat all of this. I think it will never happen. Alright, so we ate almost all of it. I'm pretty proud of myself here.
Look at the air pollution here. You literally can't see 5 kilometers away from you because the air is so polluted. It is really a shame to see.
So welcome to the city here of Jakarta. I'm having a long sleeves on, and the reason because of that is not because it is cold here. Actually, it is just opposite. It is very, very, very warm. But we're going to a mosque, and it should be open for our public. Also during Ramadan here, and it should just be a crazy big mosque. And it is actually the biggest mosque in all of Southeast Asia. It should be very impressive to see. And we just did a little bit of research about all of this and what there is to see here in Jakarta. And apparently it looks like we are very close to some attractions here. So we're just out here in the city and exploring. And it looks a little bit more civilized than when we arrived yesterday.
Okay, there's very impressive right here is the biggest mosque of Southeast Asia. And on the opposite side of the road here is a very big church. This is diversity at a very high level. And actually, it looks like there is prayer right now inside. And here during Ramadan is a very holy period for the Muslims. So apparently it is not possible to visit right now, but we are waiting here for a minute and then see if we can come inside. So all the Muslims here just finishing the afternoon prayers here. There's a lot of people here. So just getting dressed probably here.
As his as to obey the command.
So the timetable up here just shows the times where the Muslims have to pray. Very interesting to see, 6 times a day it looks like. So there's actually a lot of Muslims here just waiting here in the area until the next prayer. Wow, this is the main hall, guys. Whoa. Look at this. This is so big.
So we have a group, for example, so you can make together in the place of work.
Ah, that's nice.
No problem. So anywhere, it's actually you can take it. You can take a tree, or you can get.
So we just spent, I don't know, 45 minutes here with a guide, just explaining us everything about the Islamic culture and especially about Ramadan, who the Muslims are going through at the moment. And right now we are just at this place. Actually, this place is used 2 times a year to pray, and it can house 120,000 people. Actually, the building itself, the mosque itself, took 17 years to build, and it was finished in 1998. So a very interesting site in a religion we unfortunately know very, very, very little about. Me, myself, I'm really a non-believer, but I'm really respecting people who have a strong passion about a religion. And I think it's very, very, very cool to see and have some knowledge about why people are believing so much, because it is just so far away from me, myself, and I'm really respecting people here. It is just cool. And they are so, so, so friendly to us, and they really just want to show the mosque and the religion, and everyone was speaking to us, and they were so helpful, and I really deeply respect it here. It's it's amazing to see.
So as I told you guys before, there's a church just on the opposite side of the road here, and I think we're going to watch it. It looks very beautiful. Right, so welcome to the church here. Also very beautiful inside. So just lighting a candle here for Jesus Christ. Oh, I'm burning my fingers. Actually, this is very, very, very awesome to see. Some workers just removing plastic here from the ocean. Wow. This is the most funny job, I think, but they're doing a great job.
Okay, so we found a way for transportation to come home. Actually, here in the Jakarta, they have tuk-tuks. It's not exactly as beautiful tuk-tuks as in Thailand, but they have tuk-tuks, actually. Okay guys, so back to our hotel after our first day of exploring here in Indonesia. It's a crazy city here in Jakarta. I really don't know what to say about it, but it's a cool city, I think. I feel much more safe at a place like here than I actually did in Manila in the Philippines. So a much more safe place, I think. And they obviously have some very cool sites as well here. But yeah, I wouldn't spend too long time here. It's a nice place to spend, I don't know, 24 hours, maybe 2 days. And then exploring the city, because it is just a crazy city. It's so unbelievable here. We just ordered some room service, and I can't wait to have some lunch here. I ordered some pasta, some aglio olio, and some nachos. And Catherine, you ordered. What did you order?
Some chicken quesadilla.
Quesadilla? Chicken quesadilla?
No.
Some Mexican food.
No, chicken quesadilla. Chicken quesadilla.
Chicken
quesadilla.
Something Mexican, I think.
We ordered a lot of food.
Yeah, we ordered a lot of food.
Good afternoon,
good
sir.
Afternoon.
You're on
there? Wow, yeah. Please. Wow, so look at this. Some nachos, some chicken quesadillas, some aglio olio. Alright guys, so I'm welcome here to Jakarta by night. I just spent the last few hours inside the room just making some videos, and actually we just found out that there's this market just next to our hotel. Look at this, it's actually crazy in here, and there's so much light, you almost feel like it is daytime right now. It's a special feeling walking in here, and there's a roof, and actually we are outdoors, so special feeling, and a lot of shopping, a lot of local people here. It is so funny to be here.
Look at all of this shopping, almost like a market in Thailand, it looks like. Same things you can buy, same everything.
Okay, so inside here of a local food market, just having some local Indonesian dishes. Here in Indonesia you can get this dish called nasi goreng. It's really, really, really good. I'll show you in a minute what it is. Okay, so the nasi goreng here is some fried rice with some chicken and some vegetables
and some very good flavors. Tell me about the experience. Is it good?
It's really spicy.
Spicy. I like that.
So I'm really just working and working and working on all of these projects I have ongoing. But just a lot of practical stuff, a lot of working, trying to make a business. It's quite a hard, but I'm up for a challenge. So guys, until tomorrow, see you. Bye bye.